An inquiry into the death of a Whangārei boys high school student who was washed away on a school caving trip is set to focus on why it went ahead despite weather warnings. For Elim Christian College principal Murray Burton, the tragedy has brought back a lot of feelings. In 2008, six of his own students and a teacher were swept away in flash flooding in the Mangatepopo River. He joins us now for more on how schools cope when disasters like this happen. Murray, thank you so much for being with us this morning. And I guess as we come into this conversation, we must remember that there is a family who is hurting, a community that is hurting at the moment with the loss of this boy. So when this news broke 2 days ago, I imagine that there were a whole lot of different things, emotions that were being that were rising again for you. And I wonder how a school moves through such a tragedy like this.
You're right. Absolutely right. And for every family in the nation, the emotions rise, the feelings, the what ifs, what could have been, what happened. One day at a time, the school will be inundated with everything coming their way. My encouragement directly to you right now is for that school to look after that whānau. Absolutely look after them. They will never see their boy again alive, and they have to make sense of that, and it takes a long time. And a community in grief, it's a rippling effect. And that school is the hub of the community. Now they've got to do the business of looking after those people.
So how do they do that during a time when there is a lot of anger and again sadness, grief that is going on? How did your school work through that?
Well, there's a very little training for people like us, principals or boards, in terms of this sort of thing. But we all know that grief has to be worked through. And you have to allow the anger to come. You have to allow things to get out. Otherwise, you're not going to be whole afterwards. And you always, it's never over. You only move through each stage. And so we simply just went with our gut feeling, what we were hearing, what we were seeing, and what we were being told. I often have said over the years, I learned never to presume or assume anything. But just each day, each hour as it came, what is the next step? What should we do? How do we help people navigate just the most worst of things that could possibly happen?
Now, my understanding is that you have reached out to the principal at Whangārei Boys High School. Why did you do that, and have you had a response?
I haven't had a response because she would have been inundated with so many. But I will text her shortly and see how it's going. Look, I think it's a reminder that life is not about one person. It's about the people around you. And I am forever grateful when I look back at the people who stood around me to enable me to actually make it through. And I'm just going to encourage her today to reach out to the people. She can't do it all. And she also has to reach out to a family who can't do it all. And together they need to find a way to move forward through what is going to be a long journey.
Yeah, so how did you move through that as a principal? I'm just, you know, I'm trying to make sense of all of this and how this tragedy will be weighing heavily on so many, but also on that school.
Yeah.
How did you move through that?
Well, it's a glib thing to say, but we are a faith-based school. So our faith meant a whole lot to us at that time and still does. And so we had a connection with family based around faith. So it enabled us, I think, to have a sense of our purpose and unity right from the beginning. But look, I don't think there's one particular way to navigate this. It would be remiss of me to say to the principal of Whangārei Boys High, this is how you do it. You can read the context, read what's happening. The life is different 15 years on. The impact of social media. We never had that. Within a short space of the time of that boy missing, social media went rife with all sorts of accusations and recriminations, and that's not the time for that. We need to be, as a community, we need to, and this will be for the whole of New Zealand, Jenny May, everyone's story will be coming, welling up within them about their loss or their difficulty or whatever. We need to be a community who stands together.
We so appreciate, because I'm sure this opened up many wounds for you and for your school community as well. So we so appreciate your voice And for you, in the beautiful words that you have for the community that is now hurting in Whangārei, Murray Burton from Elim College, thank you so much for your time this morning.